Welcome to the Gavel, your weekly Denver City Council wrap-up. Here's what happened this week. On Wednesday, March 15th, the Safety, Housing, Education, and Homelessness Committee held its third and final hearing on opioids in the community. Experts from the Denver Office of the Medical Examiner, Department of Public Health, and the Anschutz Medical Campus briefed the committee on the risks of fentanyl and other drugs present in the city.
In the chart below, we've got the total number of drug deaths, and I think in 2019 it was 225 people. We had signed the death certificate as an overdose, and you can see by this year in 2022, we've got over double that, so it has continued to be an increasing problem.
There was a final briefing in a three-part series on substance misuse, addiction, and recovery meant to better inform the council's policy, budget, and oversight functions on this urgent challenge facing our city.
We have a new problem. It's being aware of this and making people aware of it is all the more paramount. Always has been a problem, always has been something to make people aware of, but now making our kids, our colleagues, everybody aware of this thing being here, and that's what we spend a lot of time doing.
For more information about substance misuse and treatment, click on the link in the description. Also on Wednesday, March 15th, the Business, Arts, Workforce, and Aviation Committee sent to the full council a pair of resolutions aimed at providing high-quality green jobs throughout the city.
The vision for the green workforce strategy is to create career pathways and expand opportunities for workers with a focus on people from under-resourced communities and individuals who are under-resourced and have barriers to employment, even if they're not located in a NEST community, and enable a just transition to support a climate-resilient and sustainable Denver.
The request is to provide an additional $300,000 for a paid training pathway program and increased wages for workers.
I'm very excited about how we are being the change we want to see in the world, and I really want to celebrate that we in the city of Denver are saying we need to protect our habitability on this planet and are willing to do something financially to help people with that transition.
In 2022, the Green Force Work Program enrolled 292 people.
Each of these trainings align with current industry demand and provide job seekers with wraparound supports, paid training, industry recognized credentials, and opportunities for advanced education or full-time employment.
Also this week, on March 13th, City Council passed a resolution approving $1.1 million to provide housing assistance for persons with AIDS. On Tuesday, March 14th, the Land Use, Transportation, and Infrastructure Committee sent to the full City Council a resolution which would add a new voting member to the Board of Directors at the National Western Center. If passed by the full council, the already existing board member representing the Globeville-Elaria-Swansea neighborhood will have a vote on the board. On March 15th, the Business, Arts, Workforce, and Aviation Committee sent to the full city council a contract with Amelie Company for $1.8 million for the city's youth marijuana education and prevention campaign. Want more information on city council, including weekly schedules and agendas? Join the Denver City Council mailing list by texting CC Schedule to 22828 or visit denvergov.org/citycouncil. Denver City Council meets every Monday at 3:30 at the City and County Building Council Chambers or tune in live on Denver 8 or Zoom. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and YouTube for Denver news, events, and information.